All right, I am at my next service call. Nice in-ground pool here. Looks like it's 20 by 40, probably 8.5, 9 feet deep. Got a diving board here. We have a Jandy JXI pool heater that homeowner's complaining smells like gas. Too much gas when it runs, and also it won't run if the water heater for the home domestic hot water is on. So let's take a look, see what's going on here. I see the gas valve, the gas cock, 3/4 inch is in the off position. Looks like a fairly new install. They got a little sloppy with the pipe dope. We have some 1.25 inch here. Going down across, looks like it's not supported to anything. And then it goes down into the ground right there. Let's go take a look at the gas meter. All right, there's a gas meter. Looks like I got 3/4 inch going into the house. And without even going inside, there's a high efficiency vent for something, another vent for something, and that's definitely an exhaust. And I'm taking a look at this gas meter. It's rated as a 250. Yeah. Yep. And you wonder why the pool heater's not working. What do you want to bet it's a 400,000 BTU pool heater? Let's take a look under the hood. Let's see what model we got here. And see if anything's out of the ordinary. Well, that's kind of weird. Got ourselves a JXI 400. All right, there's our gas valve. There's the blower assembly with the inducer motor, hot surface igniter, pressure switch for air, proving that this is running and not obstructed draft, water pressure switch, our control board, ignition module, power control board with that little board that lets us switch it in 110 or 240 volts. Let's check some pressure. I'm going to remove the little access cover on the left side, exposing the left side of the gas valve. And we're going to take an Allen key and take that little plug out and hook up our manometer to that connection. Now, I'm taking this plug out on that gas valve, making sure the gas is off. Okay, I'm going to put that down, make sure we don't lose that. And let's hook up our pressure manometer tubing right there with the connection. The barb fitting there. You don't gotta go crazy with it. Let's turn on our digital manometer. I'm using the Fieldpiece, the SDMN5. I'm gonna make sure we zero that out. I'll put links for everything in the description box down below if any of you are interested in getting this stuff. All right, turn that gas on. Looks like we have 7.5 inches of water column right there. All right, 7.5 inches of water column. Again, I'm just doing my due diligence right now, making sure that it has everything it needs in order to run and run properly. Power is off to the pool heater. Let's see, where's power? Power goes into here. I don't know where it goes. Yeah, that's our pool heater switch. Doing the startup sequence. All right, pool heater is off. Press pool or spa. It's water 71, set for 90. Look at this, pipe dope on everything. Disgusting. Okay. 7.1 inches of water column right now. We're gonna see what happens here. Right now, the system is sensing the air pressure, and that air pressure switch should be closing. Our hot surface igniter will energize as long as our water pressure switch is on, which it is, because we would have had a check flow error on the display. There's ignition, the gas valve opened. We dropped to literally nothing. No pressure there. And we go back to 7 inches of water column there. No bueno. And you gotta get good smell of gas right there. Let's check to make sure that we have proper voltage to our hot surface igniter and ohm that out next. I disconnected my two leads after turning off power to the unit at the breaker. And we're going to check for resistance on this hot surface igniter, and we have 39 ohms, so we are within range of that. Next, I'm going to get some alligator clips, and we're going to test for, actually, this will work. Right there, perfect. Let's just make sure we put that in a manner it's not going to short out anything. Just like that, perfect. Let's set that to read voltage. Let's turn back our power, make sure we have 110 volts going to our hot surface igniter. All right, I just restored power to the unit. We have just phantom voltage right now. It's not energized yet, 1.3 volts. There you go, 123 volts. So at this point, our hot surface igniter would be getting power. I'm turning off the gas. Would be getting power, and as long as we have good flow gas going through our gas valve into our ignition assembly and the combustion chamber and our burner, we would have ignition. So let's turn power back off, reconnect power to our hot surface igniter, turn the gas back on, turn the power back on, and see if she starts up. Sometimes these things are finicky, and you'll notice the first attempt doesn't always start, but your mileage may vary. All right, power's back on. Now, one observation, I'm noticing that this is a single breaker, so which means this heater is wired for 110 volts. If you reverse polarity, you're gonna get ignition failure. It'll ignite and last for about a second or two and then cut off, and you'll get ignition fault error. Check ignition steps, because your polarity is reversed. Your polarity reversed, what that means is that the hot or the line voltage coming in, 110 volts, is actually on the neutral side, and the neutral side is wired to our line voltage incoming side. And because at that polarity or that voltage is reversed, where neutral is where 110 volts is and vice versa, you're not going to have flame proofing, and you'll have ignition failure because it thinks there's no ignition, not wired properly. Let's see what goes on here now next. A little over 7 inches of water column. We'll see what happens. Okay, that was our gas valve opening. We have slight ignition for a second. We had ignition for a split second, but we're not getting enough gas, or we're not sustaining enough fuel once that main valve opens. And it looks like we're gonna have a fuel supply issue here. Now, if you take a look at our minimum gas pressure inlet, is 4 inches. And a gas orifice differential of -2.9. All right, well, we need to maintain a minimum of 4 inches of water column, even with the gas valve open, and we don't have that. I'm gonna fire this up one more time. And I know it's not going to run because we don't have enough gas. We have a improperly sized gas meter. Sometimes you get lucky, I get it. But they're trying to achieve something that's not really possible. And I get it, you know, they had this replaced another 400,000 BTU pool heater, and it probably was starving for gas at the same time. So negative 8, negative 9, negative 1, and it tries to ignite and it can't. Not enough gas. All right, just taking a look at my invoice message in the CRM that we use called House Call Pro. It allows my company to receive calls, dispatch calls electronically by means of an iPad, an iPhone, or a tablet or other phone. It allows me to bill out and receive payments. So on the invoice message, I have identified the model and serial number of the unit, that we arrived at location, and with permission, we entered the backyard. We found the pool heater in the off position, the breaker and gas, removed the top and access panels, and we visually inspected all the components. Nothing was out of the ordinary. And because the customer was smelling gas when the unit tries to fire, we proceeded with those troubleshooting steps accordingly. The igniter, I have the specs on that, 45 ohms, 123 volts at the proper sequence. Removed the access panel on the left side to expose the incoming gas pressure port on the gas valve. Got my gas readings there. Pool heater starving for fuel, which is my final diagnosis, and continued usage or attempt to use will cause irreparable damage to the combustion chamber and or the heat exchanger. The fuel pressure should be addressed by either contacting utility or a master plumber. There's my notes. We are good to go. All right, make sure the gas is off and the system is back in the state where I found it. Make sure that our test port is secure. Put back our access cover, the front, the top, all the screws, gas valve shield on top of the gas valve. Put back our plastic rubber grommet around the 3/4 inch gas piping going to the unit and make sure to leave the power off. All right, it's a few minutes to 9. I've reassembled the system. We have that error. Check ignition steps. Fault, check ignition steps. Water is 71 degrees, set for 90. The gas is off. Everything is reconnected and resecured. Let's turn the power off and give the homeowner a call. They're not home, they're not present at this time. Give them our diagnosis.